Ram TV.
Good morning, Rams. Welcome back to Ram TV. I'm Mason.
I'm Marcus.
Before we get started, if you have a family member, sibling, could be a staff member that works here at Rogers, and you want to be in the yearbook, please contact me, Aiden Horsley, or Miss Sorrell. And let's get on to the news.
This is the schedule for the Spirit Week. Today, we're doing color wars. 10th graders, you guys will be wearing white. 11th graders will be wearing navy. And 12th will be wearing
Columbia.
That's a color?
Yeah, it's like light blue.
Oh. Well, hopefully you're doing it. Alright, now we got Ping Pong Club. It's
first and second.
First and second Mondays each month. Last Tuesday each month. Meet after school in the commons by the leadership room door.
Hosting all the nationals over the past weekend, our host team went to compete in Spokane, Washington. We had 14 members go to this competition. The four of our members made top five. Divinity Singleton, first place in vet medicine. Madeline Armenta and Zachary Carriage, third place in emergency medical technician. And Julia Johnson, fourth place in vet medicine. We have three members that are automatically attending the International HOSA competition in Dallas, Texas this June. Please congratulate these people if you have class with them or you see them in the halls. Rogers Cheers tryouts required parent meeting is on March 23rd at 6 p.m. in the RHS Commons. The trial packets are due April 7th at 3 p.m. RHS Counseling Center. Required tryout clinics are April 18th, 19th, 20th at 3 p.m. in the RHS Commons. April 25th, 26th, 27th at 3 p.m. in RHS Commons. And required interview dates, April 17th and 24th between 3 to 5 p.m. There's a judge trials Friday, April 28th, starting at 5:30 p.m. March Madness food drive starts March 14th, April 7th, still going strong. I believe we get the results next week. I could be wrong, but we'll see who moves on to the next round. The format, the food drive will be held from March 14th and April 7th out of your second period class. Ask your second period teacher what college or apprenticeship you are representing in the competition. You will compete against another class each week. Winning classes moves on to the next round of the tournament. Top two classes win a prize.
For real. All right. So,
I can't see.
I think this is the pickup dates for when they're picking up the food for the food drive. So,
yeah. There's the dates.
There's the point system for the March Madness. You get 1 point for individual items or meals, 3 points for box snacks, meals, and 3 points for high priority needs like peanut butter, canned fish, canned soups, stuff like that.
Noodles.
Prizes.
First class fart. He's a fart? Yeah, I'm not winning this. Come on, class. We're going to win. You already know. Second place, donuts. Y'all ain't going to get that anyways either. So, hey. We gonna win. It don't matter. We gonna win.
Who's your class, Marcus?
Miss Stewart. Always. You know, she's like that. We're all like that, you know?
Okay.
That's news for today. I'm Marcus.
I'm Mason. There's gonna be a video for Character Strong after this. We'll see you next time.
Welcome back to Sports Recap. I'm Ben, I'm summoning him for Star. And I'm your host, Mason. On today's episode of Sports Recap, we have girls basketball, boys wrestling, and girls wrestling. Let's get into it, Rams. The boys basketball team ended their season with a conference record of 7-6 and an overall record of 10-14. Some major wins for the boys being beating South Kitsap 84-58, beating Olympia 63-60, and beating Emma Ridge twice, 70-66 and 60-47. Some key players for the team being Jackson Yoder, Isaac Briggs, Kyle Reeves, Dylan Gitterhus, Trayshawn Witherspoon, and Giovanni Conlon Allen. Now on to girls basketball.
The girls basketball team ended their season with a conference record of 7-6 and an overall all record of 11-14. Some major wins for the girls being beating Bethel by 41-38, beating GK by 49-28, and beating Pensacola by 65-55. Some key players for the girls are Divinity Singleton, Sydney Kowachuk, and Che Luker, and Madison Johnson. Now on to boys wrestling.
The boys wrestling team ended their season with a conference record of 5-2 and an overall record of 7-2. Some major matches for the boys being beating Bellarmine Prep 15-19, beating Emerald Ridge 44-28, and beating Olympia 63-13. Some key wrestlers for the boys being Curtis Carlisle, who took first at state, Kavika Simeone, who took eighth at state, and Matthew Ager, who took seventh at state. Now on to girls wrestling.
The girls wrestling team ended their season with a multiple wins and a finish at state. Some key wrestlers for the girls being Claire Bacchus, Kirsten Coleman, Lindy Strawbridge, Mia Tran, and Riley Mundell.
That's all for this episode of Sports Recap. We'll be back for the part two soon.
Connor, I heard you got a new car.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, where is it?
It's up here. Here it is.
Oh, nice.
Got it?
Yeah. It's very good. Very yellow.
Yeah. Check this out.
Yeah! Huh. All right. Okay. That's fine. Yeah.
The history of people want me to explain Transformers to you. Transformers is a franchise that started back in 1984 with the toys being brought over from Japan. Hasbro brought toy lines from Japan called Diaclone and Microchange to bring them over to America and called them Transformers. Transformers as a franchise has nearly 30 shows and 6 live action movies. The movies is what we're gonna talk about today. We're just gonna be talking about these. We're gonna start off with the first one. The movie explains to us that the Autobots and Decepticons have been fighting for millions of years on their planet, until an artifact known as the Allspark finds its way on Earth. The movie opens up with Decepticon Blackout raiding a military base so he can hack into their systems and find anything related to the Allspark in them. Shia LaBeouf gets his first car, and it turns out to be Bumblebee. Bumblebee introduces Shia to the Autobots and Optimus. They get kidnapped by the government, and they have the Allspark, as well as Megatron, the main villain. Shia LaBeouf's character saves Optimus Prime by killing Megatron with the power of the Allspark.
No, Sam!
And he saves the day. Now we have the next movie, Revenge of the Fallen. In this movie, we meet Megatron's master, known as the Fallen, who wants to blow up Earth's sun with the power of a weapon known as the Star Harvester. The Decepticons find a shard of the Allspark and use that to revive Megatron. Shia touches another piece of the Allspark, and when he touches it, a bunch of information is downloaded into his brain, and that's why the Decepticons want him. Optimus tries to save Shia, but instead he gets jumped by the Decepticons.
Because I suck!
With Optimus dead, Shia tries to revive him with the Matrix of Leadership because an old man named Jetfire told him to. He finds it, and then he revives Optimus. And then, he defeats the Fallen and destroys the Star Harvester.
You picked the wrong planet. Give me your faith.
Now let's move on to my favorite, Dark of the Moon. In this movie, we learned that an Autobot ship called the Ark crash-landed on the moon, which started the space race. Inside the ship was the Autobot leader before Optimus, Sentinel Prime. Sentinel, he created things known as the Pillars. The Pillars have the ability to open space bridges. The Autobots bring Sentinel back to Earth, and then they revive him with the Matrix. That turns out to be a bad thing, because then he kills Ironhide. Everyone blames Optimus, and then they tell the Autobots to leave Earth. In return, the Decepticons take over Chicago. The Autobots didn't actually leave, so they take back the city of Chicago. Optimus ends up killing Megatron and Sentinel, and everyone was happy, until the fourth movie where humans hate everyone now. Age of Extinction. Optimus Prime meets Mark Wahlberg and is hunted by the government, along with Gunface. Dead Their Transformers are given to a company called KSI, and they make them into man-made Transformers. KSI rebuilds Megatron into Galvatron, and he immediately takes over all their Transformers and attacks Hong Kong. Optimus gets kidnapped by Gunface, and then he meets the Dinobots. Everyone meets into Hong Kong, where there's dinosaurs and robots. Everything's bad. Optimus kills Gunface. This movie doesn't make sense. And the last night.
The Oscars happened this weekend, and
we are there.
For starters, the biggest Oscar snub of all time, in my opinion. All Quiet on the Western Front managed to edge out Babylon for Best Original Score. Now, Babylon, I liked it, but it wasn't an amazing movie, but it did have an amazing score. And also, it had the single best musical score of any movie I've ever heard. And somehow, All Quiet on the Western Front just edged it out just because it was a war film?
In the visual effects category, Avatar The Way of Water won. That's kind of expected.
I mean, how could it not? They literally invented new technology for that film. Unfortunately, Glass Onion did not win an Oscar last night, but Women Talking won the adapted screenplay instead, which I thought was very well deserved. For Best Supporting Actor and Best Supporting Actress, they both went to Everything Everywhere All at Once for Ke-Huy Quan and Jamie Lee Curtis, making it her first ever Oscar win, which is incredibly cool. Continuing with Everything Everywhere All at Once is sweet. It managed to nab film editing and Best Actress for Michelle Yeoh, making Oscar history as the first Asian woman to ever win that category, and the second ever person of color to win Best Actress. For actor in a leading role, it went to Brendan Fraser in The Whale. I thought that was very well deserved. His performance was flawless. Another big piece of Oscar history was made last night, and that was Natu from RRR won Best Original Song, making it the first and only film to win Best Original Song from India. Nick was wrong and I was right. Everything Everywhere All at Once won Best Picture as well as Best Director, which is such a huge moment for the Academy, actually giving the movie that deserved Best Picture to get it. I mean, technically I did enjoy Avatar more, but I think Everything Everywhere All at Once is undisputedly the better movie. Wouldn't you agree, Nick?
It was extremely boring.
I don't understand this man at all. That is more than all the time that we have for Pop Culture in the Closet today. My name is Nick.
His name is Reggie, mine's Nick.
Fine, and we will see you next week.
Nick. Yes, we will, with the boats.
Will we?
Maybe.
Yo, what's good? I heard
what up?
What's going on? What's good? What's good?
This Friday, you know?
Yo, you know my people love to eat. What's gonna be there?
The Ramshack's finna be open. We finna have a DJ. It's only like $5 up until the last day. Then it's 10, you know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, what's like, anything else? Anything else that the people should know about?
You know, get your tickets now as soon as possible. There's a maximum amount of people that can be there. And once it's done, it's done. That's it.
Out. Over with.